Hello everyone.
Today's topic is about blood. Today our mom will join us to share some information.
Have you ever donated blood?
To know the need of donating blood, let's get started.
The World Blood Donors Day is celebrated around the world on 14 June. To thank voluntary unpaid blood donors and to bring awareness of need of blood donation.
It is celebrated on the birth anniversary of the Nobel Prize winner Karl Landsteiner, and the theme of this year is Save Blood, Saves Life, and the slogan is Give Blood and Make the World a Healthier Place. Now my mom is going to share some information.
Hello everyone, today I will discuss about blood donation, how it is useful to us and even for the society. Okay, as per a recent study, India is facing a large shortage of blood. What will happen if there is shortage of blood? Due to the unavailability of blood, in time, the patient will die. Why do we need blood? We may need the blood when we undergo some surgery, when we met with an accident, or if we have some disease. In above three cases, if we don't get the blood in time, we may definitely die. So, what we have to do? It's necessary that we have to create a pool of blood in the blood banks, which can be used in the times of need. Okay, then why people are not going and donating? Because most of the people fear that they may become weak if they donate blood, or their immune system may get affected. So now I'll clear most of your doubts, misconceptions and myths which are rooted in our brains from long ago. The first question which raises in everyone's mind when we ask them to donate blood in need, the first thing they get the doubt that they may become weak, their immune system may get affected, they may faint after giving the blood. See, it will not happen like that, because before blood donation, the criteria and whether you are eligible or not will be checked. Only then the blood will be taken from you. So, if you are eligible for donating the blood, it means that you are healthy enough to give blood and nothing will happen to you. Okay, the second question. In how many hours or days we will get back the blood, or in how many hours the blood will be replaced again in our body? It will just take 48 hours for the plasma to replace in your body, and it will take few weeks for the RBC to be replaced in your blood. Who should not give the blood? The people who are having the diseases which will be transmissible by the blood are not allowed to donate the blood. And even the people who are weak, and if they donate blood and if it is risk to their life, they are also not allowed to give the blood. Okay, there are few guidelines which I'll discuss later. Okay, next thing, how frequent can I donate my blood? It is generally once in 3 months. For men, after 12 weeks, they can happily give the blood again. But for women, they have to wait for 16 weeks to donate their blood. Why? What is the difference? Because men will be having more hemoglobin than the woman. So, there is a difference of weeks just to recover. The other most common doubt is, what should I eat before or after blood donation? You have to eat the food which is rich in iron before and after giving your blood. And it's good if you drink more of fluids before giving your blood. The common doubt which will be hitting the woman is, can I donate my blood in menstruation? Yes, you can donate the blood, but you have to check with the cases. If you are normally bleeding and if you are okay and healthy, you feel that you are okay to give the blood, then you can go and give. But in case you are bleeding heavily, don't risk, because already you are losing your blood. So don't risk your life and don't donate the blood in times of menstruation. Rest of the time, women can happily donate their blood. Other thing, many of the people will be asking me, will our blood used immediately after we donate? No. In some cases, it will be used immediately, like in the cases where they need the donors, like live donors. Okay. But most of the cases, the blood will be stored. Like the RBC can be stored for 42 days and then it will be used. But whereas in the case of platelets, it must be used within 5 days. Okay. how much blood is taken from me when I want to donate my blood. Don't worry, they usually take a unit of blood like 350 ml. Even if you want to give more, they will not accept. Okay? The other thing, many of the people will be asking me, what is the benefit I'll get if I donate blood? You can maintain a healthy lifestyle. And the second thing, there will be reduced risk of cancer. Third, there will be reduced risk of damage of liver and pancreas. You can even improve your cardiovascular health, and it helps in fighting the obesity. And the doubt which arises in most of the people is, what if my blood is sold? Like, what if it is misused? See, there are three types of donors. Okay, one is voluntary donor. They are very much useful for the society. Second one is replacement. Generally, they are the relatives of the patient or friends of the patient who give their blood as replacement for getting the required blood of the patient. Third one are professional donors. These people donate the blood in exchange of money. So you don't worry that your blood will be misused, because you will be giving to a proper blood bank or for the patient directly when they are in need. If you still have a doubt that no, I don't want to get into this, and I don't want people, I don't want to let the people misuse my blood, then do one thing. When there will be a need posted, like a particular blood is required, and if you belong to that blood group, then you can contact the attendee or the people or the organization who are collecting the blood for the particular patient. And you can directly go to the hospital and then you can donate there itself. Okay? Like, how I will be knowing which organization is working in this? I have few list of organization with whom I am working, and they are very much trustworthy. So you can contact them, and even they are maintaining the groups in FB, WhatsApp. You can join them if you are interested in this blood group donation and all. And if you cannot even donate, like if you are not qualifying the eligibility criteria like the weight or hemoglobin, no problem. At least you can help as a volunteer in arranging the blood in times of need. So you can join the any of the group. I don't say that you have to join the group in which I am working. You can join in any of the blood groups. There are n number which are working. But if more number of volunteers and more number of donors will be increased, then we can fight with the shortage of the blood. Okay, see. Many of you will not be aware of the thalassemia kids who need regular transfusion of blood. There is a lot of shortage of blood where they every time suffer because of the lack of blood. So please, if you are willing to donate blood, they will be conducting blood camps when and then. You can join them and donate for the little ones. Now I'll share you some general guidelines you need to follow when you are willing to donate blood. Okay, first thing is, your hemoglobin should be at least 11. Your weight should be at least 45 kgs. Your temperature should be normal. Who can donate the blood? You should be above 18 years of age, and nearly like till 65 years you can go and donate your blood. Actually, there is no upper age limit for donating blood, but on a safe side you can donate till 65 years. Okay, you shouldn't be drinking on donation, and you have to clearly mention about your medical history. You should even have the risk assessment before donating the blood. Okay, you should give the true and clear information about your past history, like if you are having any transmissible diseases or not. You should be giving all that information before donating. Online blood donors group founded by Krishna Agarwal. They are working day and night and 24/7 for providing blood to the needy. You can join them if you are interested in the same service. They are providing blood to the needy not just in the state in which they are living, but they are working for Pan India. In Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Jharkhand, Haryana, Punjab, Maharashtra, and even they are having some volunteers who are working from abroad. Call for Blood organization started by Venkana Babu. They will be working for areas like Machilipatnam, which come under the Krishna district, and the nearby districts also he'll be arranging blood. Even for Vijayawada he's working. So you can even join them if you are from that region or from any other region, and if you are interested to work for that organization, you can join them. Kerala also started a blood donation group recently in WhatsApp. You can even join them if you want to. They are serving for Visakhapatnam and the nearby towns like Srikakulam, Vijayanagaram, etc. So, if you would like to join any of the organization, you can join as per your wish, or you can even search in Google to get more information about all other blood donation groups which are working. Thank you. Don't wait till something happens to us. Like, only when something happens to me, then only I'll realize the need of blood or the realize the need of blood donation. Please don't wait till that thing. If we all fight together, if we all donate blood, and if we cannot donate blood, if we join a group and arrange the donors, then there will not be any shortage of the blood and we can easily tackle the shortage of the blood. See, most of us are young people who can definitely work by using this social media in arranging the blood in time. So I hope you all will realize the essence of blood donation and come forward either in donation or by arranging the blood for the needy in time. Thank you so much.
Thanks for watching our video. If you like our video, please like, share and subscribe. Don't forget to share this useful information to all. Bye bye.